能听到我说话吗？
我听到了。
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Please accept our humble obeisance. All glory to Shri
Krishna. 好，我们开始。Om Magyana Timurandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya
Recording in progress
Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Dalyanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Okay, we're reading the Brihad Bhagavatamrita and we're on the second chapter of the first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
我们在读的这本书是《大伯加瓦堂纲目》，现在我们已经读到了第二章的第一部分。
Narada Muni is searching for the devotee who has received the greatest mercy of Lord Krishna.
Narada Muni 正在寻找到底是哪位奉献者得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
So.He, in his search, he was sent first of all to the south of the southern region. There was a king there, but the king sent him to the heavenly planets, to Indra.
在他的寻找过程当中，他首先找到了南部区域的一位国王。这个国王呢，就将拿的穆尼就指引向了天堂的 Indra。
So, Narada Muni was talking to Indra, but Indra told him, "No," he said, "I'm not the person who got the real mercy from Krishna. It's actually Lord Brahma."
当 Narada Muni 跟 Indra 谈话的时候，Indra 就说，不，我并没有得到主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。是 Brahma 得到了最大的仁慈。
Indra told Narada Muni that the Lord hardly ever, he just comes here and he accepts the offering and then he goes. He doesn't stay here. But on Brahma Loka, on the planet of Brahma, the Lord stays there all the time.
Indra 就告诉 Narada 说至尊主他在这里接受了供奉之后，他不会在这里久留，之后他就走了。但是在 Brahma 的星球上呢，至尊主他恒常的在那里。
So, he said there are many other reasons why Brahma is, he's the real person who got the greatest, he's the real object of Krishna's mercy.
还有其他的种种的理由，就可以说明是 Brahma 得到了主的最大的仁慈。
And Indra said, "This is stated both in the Shruti and in the Smriti. The Shruti means the original Vedas, and the Smriti are the supplements of the Vedas."
而这一点呢，就在 Shruti 和 Smriti 当中得到了证实。Shruti 是原始的韦达经。Smriti 是韦达经的补充文献。
And Indra says to Narada Muni, "You must know about the position of Brahma. He's very great, and all the people who live on his planet also, they're all great souls."
Indra 就对 Narada 说，你一定知道呢 ，Brahma 是特别了不起的灵魂。而居住在 Brahma Loka 上的呢，也都是了不起的灵魂。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it tells us that Brahma is an empowered incarnation of Vishnu.
圣典波迦瓦坛就告诉我们说，主 Brahma 是 Vishnu 的一个被授予权力的化身。
Yeah, in the Srimad Bhagavatam it states that Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva, and Indra are all. Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva are the cause of the material manifestation.
圣典波迦瓦坛就声明说, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva 是宇宙展示的根源.
And the Lord is the super soul. He's a witness of everything.
主是超灵，是万事万物的证人。
And on the impersonal platform, there's no difference between Brahma and Shiva and Vishnu.
在非人格的层面上, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, 他们没有区别。
Vishnu is the original personality of Godhead, and he creates,
Vishnu,
maintains, and annihilates the cosmic manifestation through Brahma and Vishnu and Shiva.
You mean Krishna or Vishnu is the original cause of...
Okay, we can say Krishna.
Okay. Now Krishna is the original cause. He is through Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva to create and destroy this world.
And Krishna acts through the material energy according to the different activities through which his representations are named. I don't know what that means. Anyway, it says, Lord Krishna is the original personality of Godhead, but he does the creation, maintenance, and annihilation through his agents like Brahma and Shiva and Vishnu.
Krishna is the original creation.
So we should understand that Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, and the living entities are all separate from the Supreme. They're not separate from the. They're not separate from the Supreme.
Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, and the Supreme themselves are not separate.
And we should know that Brahman, one who knows Brahman, he actually gets peace. And without knowing Brahman, you will not be peaceful. So when Narada Muni heard this from Indra, Narada Muni said, well, and thank you very much, it's very nice. And he immediately, Narada Muni, went to Brahma's planet. And when Brahma came, when Narada came to Brahma Loka, then he could hear so much noise, he could hear the sound of, they were performing many great sacrifices.
当Narada在远处的时候，他就听到了从祭祀，因为祭祀发出的巨大的声响。All
the great sages who live there on Brahmaloka, that's what they do, they perform sacrifices.
正是居住在Brahmaloka上的那些伟大的圣者们，他们正在举行 祭祀。
So Vedic sacrifice can be done in a very simple way, or they can be done very elaborately, according to how much facilities and how ambitious a person is.
根据人的能力以及根据人的愿望，韦达祭祀既可以是简单的举行，也可以是非常繁复的举行。
So the people, the sages who live on Brahma's planet, they like to do the longest and the most complex sacrifices.
就像在 Brahma Loka 上面的圣者们喜欢举行时间很长的以及最细致入微的祭祀。
So when Narada came there to Brahma Loka, he could hear so much noise of all the different sacrifices being performed, and he could, it appeared like it's a very busy place.
当 Narada 来到 Brahma 的星球的时候，他可以听到各式各样的祭祀来发出的声响，他感觉到这是一个非常忙碌的地方。
And then Narada Muni could see, among the sages, he could see the Supreme Lord in the form of the Mahapurusha.
在圣者们当中，他看到至尊主呈现为 Mahapurusha 的形象。
And the Lord Mahapurusha looked very satisfied, and he's decorated with his hair's all matted locks, you know, the hair on his head's all matted.
他看上去是心满意足的，他的头发是缠结的，一缕一缕的。
So this form of the Mahapurush has 1,000 heads.
Mahapurush 形象拥有一千个头。
And he's the personification of sacrifice, and he came there with his consort to accept the offerings and to please all the people who are worshipping him.
他来到祭祀现场是为了接受供奉，并且满足这些崇拜者们，他带着他的伴侣一起来。
So Mahapurusha is the presiding deity there. And he's the originator of sacrifices.
Mahapurush is 那里的主宰神像，他也是所有献祭的创始人。
It's mentioned in the Purusha Shukta prayers in the Rig Veda that at the beginning of the creation, the first sacrifice in the universe was performed.
在 Rig Veda 经当中。的 Purusha Shukta 赞美诗当中就说到了，在创造之始，宇宙当中举行了第一场祭祀。
And for this very first sacrifice, the Lord in the form of Mahapurusha, he provided all the sacrificial ingredients from his own body.
在这场献祭当中，主 Mahapurusha就从自己的身体当中提供了献祭的所有元素。
So the Lord shows himself in this form of the Mahapurusha on Brahma Loka, but he takes this form not just to take the offerings, but to please the people worshipping him.
主本人就在 Brahma Loka 上揭示了自己的这个形象，他不仅仅是为了接受供奉，而且是为了取悦那些崇拜者们。
And the Lord Mahapurusha personally distributes the results of sacrifice.
Mahapurusha 亲自派发了祭祀的所有的结果。
To enliven Lord Brahma.The Lord, in the form of Mahapurusha, ate all the items offered to him.
为了让 Brahma 生机勃勃，主就亲自接受了所有供奉的物品。
He placed them all into his thousand mouths with his thousand hands.
他用他的上千只手接把所有贡品都放进了他的上千个口中。
So after they performed the sacrifice, then the Lord gave them the benedictions all the sages desired.
满足了所有祭祀的献祭者的时候，主就祝福他们，使他们心想事成。
Now, according to the benedictions they desired, he satisfied their desires.
根据他们想得到的祝福，至尊主就满足了他们的愿望。
And then the Lord Mahapurusha went to his sleeping quarters.
这之后，至尊主马哈普鲁舍就去了他的寝室。
And the goddess of fortune Lakshmi massages his feet, and he entered his pastime of sleep.
幸运女神 Lakshmi 按摩了他的足之后，马哈普鲁舍就进入到他睡眠的逍遥时光。
So the people who are worshipping the Mahapurusha, they may be worried if he is actually enjoying all the offerings they're making to him.
这些马哈普鲁舍的崇拜者们，他们怀疑至尊主到底有没有享受他们的所有供奉。
So to please them, that's why the Mahapurusha would eat the offerings.
正是为了取悦他们的缘故，马哈普鲁舍所以才吃掉了所有的供品。
And he'd eat with great relish and without hesitation.
他毫不犹豫地津津有味地来吃掉了所有的贡品。
And when he'd finished eating, he'd bless all the sages, give them their blessing, give them benedictions.
在吃完之后呢，他就给了这些圣者们祝福。
And satisfy all their desires.
满足他们所有的愿望。
Desires, they would desire that they could always be able to perform the sacrifice.
他们的心愿就是能够永远举行这些祭祀。
And then the goddess of fortune and the Mahapurusha would go to their private quarters to take rest.
之后，主马哈普鲁舍和幸运女神就去了他们的私人寝室休息。
So when he would go to take rest, then the Mahapurusha is no longer visible to the people of Brahmaloka.
当他们去休息之际 ，Brahmaloka 上的居民就，在这个期间就不能看见他们。
So the Lord on Brahmaloka has two pastimes.
在 Brahmaloka 上面的至尊主。他有两个逍遥时光。
One is he accepts the sacrifices, and the other is his sleeping.
第一个是接受祭品，第二个是休眠的逍遥时光。
So that's described in the Mahabharata.
这在《Mahabharata》这部书当中也描述了。
There it says there that. He saw the Lord and yet another of his forms consuming the shade. Yeah, it's described there in the Mahabharata. There's a great sage called Vaishampayana Rishi, and he's describing about the killing of the demon Kalanemi.
这是由一个圣者名叫 Vaishampayana Rishi 描述杀死
So Vaishampayana is saying that he saw the Lord in another of his forms. That's the Mahapurusha. He saw the Lord in the form of Mahapurusha consuming the share of the oblations of ghee offered in sacrifice.
这个圣者就说，他看见主在他的另一个形象，他吃掉了酥油的贡品， 这是由伟大的圣者们在祭祀当中所供奉的。
And then the thousand-headed Lord, in other words, the Mahapurusha, his heads were all covered with the matted locks, then he entered his room to lay down to sleep.
之后上千个头颅的 Mahapurusha, 他有着缠结的卷发，他就去了他的休息的地方，进入了休眠。
Now in the Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, at the beginning of the 10th canto, it describes how at the end of Dwapara Yuga, Lord Brahma and the demigods went to approach Lord Vishnu.
在圣典博迦瓦坛第十篇的开始的时候，描述说在 Dwapara, 同庆年代的末期， Brahma 和其他半神人
Right, this is also described in our Krishna book. Everyone who reads the Krishna book will know at the beginning of the Krishna book it describes how Lord Brahma and all the demigods go to pray to Lord Vishnu. This is in our
Vishnu
book.
Brahma 和所有的半神人们，他们去找 Vishnu。
Yeah, they came because the earth personified. The earth was overburdened with all the demonic kings.
他们来的原因是因为地球充斥了那些恶魔、邪恶的国王。
So they came to pray to Lord Vishnu. They prayed to Vishnu on Sweta Dweep. Sweta Dweep. Lord Vishnu also resides on Sweta Dweep And the Lord Brahma was at the shore of the Milk Ocean. And in the Milk Ocean, there's the island of Sweta Dweep, and Lord Vishnu resides there.
Right.
They needed to. So somebody may ask, if Vishnu is always in Brahma's place, if Lord Vishnu is always living there on Brahma's planet, why did they go to Sweta Dweep to pray to Vishnu?
有人会产生疑惑。既然 Vishnu 本人居住在 Brahma 的星球上，为什么他们还要去 Sweta Dweep 去找他呢？
So, some days of Brahma, the pastime of getting Lord Krishna to descend, you know, there's different ways in which they describe the pastime of Lord Krishna coming to this world.
对于 主 Krishna 降临到这个世界，就有不同的描述方式。
Right. It depends on different days of Brahma, different ways. And so it's described in one book, in the Harivamsa, how Lord Vishnu was approached on Brahma Loka.
在 Harivamsa 这部书当中呢，他就描述了，在 Brahma 的某一天，他们就来到了 Brahma 的星球。
So you should understand, Lord Vishnu is in Brahma Loka there, but he's also on Sweta Dweep. So sometimes they go to Lord Vishnu at Sweta Dweep, and sometimes they go to Lord Vishnu at Brahma Loka.
所以要理解，就是 Vishnu 他不仅仅居住在 Brahma 的星球上。他也居住在 Sweta Dweep， 就某一天，在 Brahma 的某一天，他们会去 Brahma Loka 上去找 Vishnu， 在另外一天，他们会去 Sweta Dweep 去找 Vishnu。
So Sanatana Goswami tells us that he says that Brahma and the others went to Sweta Dweep because they didn't want to disturb the Mahapurusha if he was sleeping.
Sanatana Goswami 描述说 ，Brahma 和其他的半神人去了 Sweta Dweep， 因为他们不想打扰主的睡眠。
Or another reason is that Brahma may have thought that if the Mahapurusha was to come to earth at his request, Brahma would not have his association.
或者是 Brahma 就这样想，如果 Brahma 和半神们请求 Mahapurusha 降临地球的话，他本人就在 Brahma Loka 上得不到Mahavishnu 的联谊了、Mahapurush 的联谊、
Because the Mahapurush will appear as the avatar, he will come to the earth for his incarnation, and then after he finishes his appearance as the avatar, then only he can go back. And so they would lose his association in Brahmaloka.
因为一旦 Mahapurush 化身前来地球的话，在地球上显现的话，在 Brahmaloka 上他们就失去了与 Mahapurusha 的联谊。
And so Brahma thought it would be better if he go to the milk ocean and ask Lord Vishnu to become the avatar.
所以 Brahma 想，那最好还是去牛奶之洋的 Shrikadvip 去找那里的 Vishnu， 请那里的 Vishnu 化身降临地球吧。
Anyway, we should understand when Krishna comes to this world.All the expansions of the Godhead appear within him.
无论如何，应当理解，当 Krishna 降临地球的时候，所有神兽的化身都和他一起降临了。
So when Lord Krishna comes, it includes the Mahapurusha and it includes also the Lord of Svetadvip.
因此，当 Krishna 降临地球的时候，Mahapurusha 以及 Svetadvip 上的Vishnu 也都一起来了。
It doesn't matter if Krishna comes from Vishnu or from some other incarnation.
所以无论是 Krishna 是来是是从其他Vishnu 还是从其他的化身而来，那都无所谓。
Krishna is the source of all the avatars.
Krishna 是所有化身的源头。
So the Mahapurusha requests Brahma and his sons to continue the sacrifice.
Mahapurusha 就请求 Brahma 及其众儿子们继续他们的祭祀。
And Brahma went to his own palace, to his own royal court, to think about the management of the universe.
Brahma 就回到他自己的居所，他的大庭上来继续思考宇宙的创造事宜。
So this was just before the Mahapurusha went to take rest. At that time, he told Brahma to get your sons to do the sacrifice.
在 Mahapurusha 去休息之前，他告诉 Brahma 说：“让您的儿子们继续举行祭祀。”
So, this is the Vedic system that Brahma's sons became the authorities in Vedic sacrifice.
所以这就是伟达的制度 ，Brahma 的儿子们就成了伟达献祭的权威。
Brahma is the first Vedic priest, and then after Brahma, then Brahma's sons become the Vedic priest.
Brahma 是第一位伟达的祭司，在 Brahma 之后，是他的儿子们就成为了伟达的祭司。
And his sons teach us how to perform sacrifice.
他的儿子们教导我们该如何举行献祭。
So.Lord Brahma was sitting comfortably on his throne and he was absorbed in hearing and reciting the glories of the Lord.
Brahma 就舒适地坐在他的皇座上、宝座上，专注地聆听和背诵主的荣耀。
And as he was hearing the glories of the Lord, tears were flowing from all of his eight eyes.
在他聆听主的荣耀之际， 泪水从他的八只眼睛当中流淌下来。
And surrounding Brahma, with Brahma at that place and with him, there was all the personified powers of the universe.
在 Brahma 四周环绕着宇宙的所有力量的化身。
So Brahma is the father of Narada Muni. So Narada came close and he offered his respects. He fell on the ground like a stick and then spoke to Lord Brahma.
Brahma 是 Narada 的父亲，所以当 Narada 接近的时候，他就像根棍子一样在他的父亲面前直挺挺地倒在地上。
So when the Mahapurusha was present, Narada didn't say anything. He didn't speak what was in his mind.
当 Mahapurusha 在场的时候， Narada 并没有讲出他心意里的想法。
He thought it might not be proper for him to speak.
他觉得那时候他开口讲话并不恰当。
Or he didn't get an opportunity to speak until after the Lord had gone away.
或者说，直到主离开之际，Narada才有机会开口讲话。
And then only Narada could offer his obeisances to his father.
而且只有在那个时候 ，Narada 才有机会向他的父亲顶拜。
Because it wouldn't be proper etiquette to worship somebody else in the presence of the Supreme Lord.
因为在至尊主的面前去崇拜其他人，这并不符合礼节。
Now Lord Brahma is not only Narada's father, but he's also his spiritual master.
Brahma 不仅仅是 Narada 的父亲，还是他的灵性导师。
So in the presence of Lord Vishnu, Narada maybe bowed his head to Brahma.
在 Vishnu 面前 ，Narada 也许仅仅是向 Brahma 向 Brahma 低头致意。
But after Lord Vishnu left, then he bowed down with his whole body.
但是在 Vishnu 离开的时候，Narada 就用整个的身体向Narada 向 Brahma 致意。
And Brahma was giving his whole attention. He was hearing about the qualities of Lord Vishnu.
而 Brahma 此时正在全神贯注地聆听 Vishnu 的荣耀。
He was hearing about the kindness of Lord Vishnu to his devotees.
他在聆听 Vishnu 是如何对他的奉献者仁慈有加的。
So Narada says to Lord Brahma, he said, "It is you who have really received the mercy of Lord Hari."
Narada 对 Brahma 说，是您真正的得到了主的福仁慈。
You are the master of all the masters of the living beings of the universe.
你是这个宇宙间所有众生的主人的主人。
You are the grandfather of all the worlds.
你是三个世界的祖父。
You create and you maintain and you devour the 14 worlds.
您创造、维系、吞噬着全部的世界。
And you rule the universe and you are the self-born.
您统治着宇宙，您也是自我诞生者。
So Narada is telling us about the reasons why he thinks Brahma is the most favored devotee of the Lord.
Narada 就这样来讲述为什么他认为 Brahma 是主的最宠爱的人。
Other demigods like Indra, their reign is limited, but Brahma's rule is not limited.
其他的统治者，比如说 Indra。他们的统治期限是有限的，但是 Brahma 却不是这样。
Brahma keeps his position without any interruption.
Brahma 是不受打扰的，保持着自己的地位。
In the lower regions of the universe, sometimes there will be partial annihilations.
在宇宙的低等区域，也许会有部分的毁灭。
But these don't affect Lord Brahma.
但是这个毁灭不会影响到 Brahma。
And Narada says to Brahma, he said, in your assembly,you have the Vedas and the Puranas and other scriptures. All the people who speak the truth, they're all born from your four mouths.
Brahma 继续，Narada 继续对 Brahma 说，在您的议事大厅有《北达经》、《往事书》，还有其他的经典。这些都是真理的揭示者，他们都诞生于您的四个口中。
We should understand the four Vedas are eternal.
我们应当明白四部伟大经是永恒的。
But they enter the material world periodically at the beginning of each day of Brahma.
但是在 Brahma 的一天的开始他们会间祸地进入到物质世界。
One Veda will appear from each of the four mouths of Brahma.
四部伟大经的每一部都会从 Brahma 的四个口当中诞生出现。
So the author of the Vedas, Brahma therefore is...Brahma is not the author of the Vedas.
Brahma 并不是伟达经的作者。
The Vedas give us all spiritual and material knowledge.
伟达经给予世人所有的灵性以及物质知识。
But Brahma is the first authority of Vedic knowledge in the universe.
然而 ，Brahma 却是这个宇宙间伟大知识的第一位权威。
So he's described as Adi Kavi, the original poet, or the original learned person.
所以 ，Brahma 被称之为 Adi Kavi， 也就是第一位诗人，或者是第一位博学的人。
So Narada tells Lord Brahma, he said, your world.In other words, Brahma Loka can only saintly persons can come here who are performing their duty without any fault and who are without any pride. And they have no vices and they have to do like that for 100 lifetimes. Then only they can come to your planet.
Narada 赞美 Brahma 说你的新世界只能由那些没有错误的履行他们的社会职责，没有骄傲、毫无虚荣、毫无邪恶之心的履行了100年这样的职责的圣人们，才能达到你所居住的星球。
So Brahma is a perfect character.And his planet is also very perfect, very glorious.
Brahma 的品格是崇高的、完美的，他的星球也是荣耀的。
And in order to go to Brahma's planet, you have to be very pure, you have to be very saintly for 100 lifetimes.
为了能得到那达到 Brahma 的星球，一个人必须是非常纯粹，非常的崇高。他在100世，他都有这样的品格。
You have to be free of pride, and you cannot be deceitful.
一个人他必须是摆脱了傲慢之心，而且是不应当有欺骗之心。
Then only you're eligible to take birth on Brahmaloka.
之后他才有资格在 Brahma 的星球上诞生。
This was told by Lord Shiva when Lord Shiva was instructing the Prachetas.
当主 Shiva 来训示那些 Prachetas 们的时候，这是 Shiva 的话。
Lord Shiva told them that a person who does his duties properly for 100 births, he becomes qualified to take the post of Brahma.
主 Shiva 说。一个人正确地履行自己的职责100世，他才有资格占据 Brahma 的职位。
So the position of Brahma, which is given to the position of Brahma is usually given to pious workers.
Brahma 的这个地位呢，只能给那些虔诚的工作者。
And sometimes they won't become Brahma, but they'll just become an associate of Brahma.
有的时候他们不能成为 Brahma, 但是却可以成为 Brahma 的同游。
And sometimes they'll be given a universe of their own to rule.
有时候他们被赐予一个他们自己的新宇宙来统治。
But it's very rare.
但这种情况非常罕见。
So in the universe is no higher planet than Brahmaloka.
在这个宇宙当中没有比 Brahma 更高的星球了。
Even Lord Narayan's Vaikuntha planet is inside this world.
甚至连主 Narayan 的星球 ,Narayan 的星球也在这个世界当中。
On Brahmaloka, Lord Narayan always resides in his manifested form as the Mahapurusha.
在 Brahmaloka 上，主 Narayan 呢，总是以他的莲花肚脐的 Mahapurusha 的形象居住在那里。
And he, the Lord Mahapurusha, eats his share of sacrifice, and he gives the results of sacrifice.
马哈普鲁舍不仅吃掉了他的献祭的祭品，而且他能够赐予献祭的结果。
So, in the past, in the Narada Muni speaking to Brahma, he said, "In the past, you made many attempts, but you were not able to find him."
那儿的就对 Brahma 说，在过去您做了种种的尝试，但是却无法找到他。
And after you did a lot of austerities, you finally saw the Supreme Lord just for a moment in your heart.
经历了种种苦行之后，您最终在您的内心看见了他，但是只是片刻的时间。
So the Lord Brahma was born from the navel of the Supreme Lord, from the Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
主 Brahma 是从 Garbhodaksha 孕蛋之羊 Vishnu 的肚脐上诞生的。
So it's very rare to find the Lord Mahavishnu, to find Garbhodaksha Vishnu.
能够找到 Garbhodaksha Vishnu 是非常非常罕见的。
So the fact that Brahma actually found the Lord is evidence that the Lord had given him mercy.
Brahma 能够找到主这一事实本身就证明了他得到了主的仁慈。
Lord Brahma wanted to find out where he had come from, and he entered the stem of the lotus flower.
主 Brahma 想要了解他的始源，因此他就潜入到这个莲花茎当中。
So he searched out, he went into the stem, and he went back and he searched.And he said, trying to find out where the lotus was coming from.
To Brahma, he 潜入到这个莲花茎当中，然后又生 升上来之后，他又再次潜入到这个莲花镜当中，他想要了解这根莲花镜是从哪里出来的。
And he went into the lower regions of the universe, but he could not find anything.
之后他又进入到这个宇宙的低等区域当中，但是他却一无所获。
He couldn't find the Lord, and he couldn't even locate the Lord physically.
他既找不到主，他也无法确切地知道主他的区域，他到底在哪里。
But then Lord Vishnu graced him with special instruction.
之后主就给了他一个特殊的训谕，以此向他展示仁慈。
And he told him to do austerity.
主训示 Brahma 要去苦行。
So Brahma followed the instruction and he meditated for a long time.
Brahma 遵守了主的训谕，就冥想了很长一段时间。
And after he meditated for a long time, he got a short, very brief vision of the Lord.
在冥想了很长一段时间之后，他在短暂的片刻看见了主。
So this is described in the second and third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. So Narada says to Brahma, you are surely the most dear devotee of Lord Krishna.
Brahma 对 Narada 对 Brahma 说，我毫无疑问，您是 Krishna 最亲爱的奉献者了。
And he says to Brahma, you are Krishna himself appearing in various bodies for your pastimes.
Narada 对 Brahma 说，您就是主 Krishna 本人，您是以各种他以各种各样的躯体显现来展示他的消失光。
So Brahma may not be very happy to hear himself being called Krishna, and he may argue, I'm not.
听到自己被称为 Krishna, Brahma 会很不高兴，他也许会提出反驳意见。
The Lord is sitting there in the Mahapurusha form with his 1,000 heads.
主就坐在这里，他是 Mahapurusha 的形象，他有上千个头颅。
And in addition to this form, he has many, many other forms.
除了这个形象之外，他还有许许多多其他的形象。
But Brahma thinks, I am different. I am someone different. I'm just a finite living being with only 4 heads.Brahma thinks, I'm insignificant. I'm just an ordinary person. I only have 4 heads. Mahapurusha has 1,000 heads.
Brahma,
so among the Lord's infinite pastimes appear... So Narada says that the Lord appears for the sake of creation, maintenance, and destruction in the form of Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. And each of them are not different from the original Supreme Person.
Brahma 说主以创造者、维系者和毁灭者的形象，以 Brahma、Vishnu 和 Shiva 的形象，来创造、维系和毁灭。而这三个形象呢， 都和原始的至尊者本人没有区别。
So this way Narada Muni is praising Brahma and he bows before him with great devotion again and again.
Narada 就以这样的方式来赞美着 Brahma, 并且在他面前一再的起立又顶拜。
And Narada was singing the glories of Lord Brahma as he had heard them from Indra and he'd seen with his own eyes.
那他就这样描述着他从 Indra 那里听来的 Brahma 的荣耀，并且这也是他亲眼目睹到的。
Indra had told Narada that Lord Brahma is the actual son of Lord Vishnu, and he is the husband of Lakshmi.
Indra 告诉 Narada, Brahma 是 Vishnu 的儿子。而 Vishnu 是幸运女神的丈夫。
So Narada knew from the scriptures the glories of Brahma, and now he was actually seeing them.
Narada 从经典当中了解到 Brahma 的荣耀，并且现在他亲眼的看到了。
So now we're going to hear the Lord Brahma. He's not very happy to hear.Narada speak all this praise of him.
接下来我们会听到 Brahma 听到 Narada 对他的这一番赞美之词，他并不很高兴。
Brahma became disturbed hearing Narada speak like this.
相反 ，Brahma 听到 Narada 的这一席话之后，内心很受打扰。
Brahma covered his 8 ears.And he said again and again, I am just a servant, I'm just a servant.
Brahma 堵住了他的八只耳朵，反反复复地说，我只是个仆人，我只是仆人。
And so Brahma, but he had to control his anger because he was not pleased to hear this.
Brahma 必须得按耐他内心的愤怒，因为他听到这一席话之后很不高兴。
He didn't like. He had to tell his son Narada that you shouldn't speak like this.
他必须要告诉他的儿子 Narada, 你可不能这样说话。
Because Brahma works with the mode of passion, Brahma is in charge of the mode of passion.So sometimes, briefly, he's affected by anger.
Because Brahma is 掌管着激情属性，所以有的时候他也受到激情的影响。
So because Narada was praising him improperly, so he almost lost his temper.
Because Narada, 并不正确的赞美了他，所以，Brahma 本人呢，几乎是要发脾气了。
Because Narada Muni was trying to say that, you know, you are the Supreme Lord, you are the independent Supreme Lord. So Brahma knew he's not. So he became angry.
Narada 竟然称 Brahma 是独立的至尊主，所以 Brahma 本人十分清楚他不是，因此他变得生气了。
So Brahma says to Narada, he said, I am not the Supreme Lord Krishna.
Brahma 就对 Narada 说，我不是至尊主 Krishna.
What authority and what logic do you say this?
你根据哪个权威，并且你凭借什么样的逻辑推理来这样说话呢？
And Brahma said, Constantly, I've been teaching you since you were a little boy. I've been teaching you about this.
从你是一个小男孩的时候，我就不断的来教导你这一点。
So, it's a custom in Brahminical culture that we should not claim anything unless you can support it with the Vedic evidence from the scriptures.
按照伟达的文化，除非我们得到了经典的证据的话，否则不能胡言乱语。
So Brahma challenged Narada Muni. He said, where is the evidence for this?
Brahma 就挑战Narada 说你说这番话证据何在呢？
And we know in the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, we heard Brahma had been educating Narada Muni about spiritual science.
我们知道在圣典博迦瓦塔第二篇当中， Brahma 就教导了 Narada 有关灵性的科学。
His personal energy is Mahamaya, and it stands within his sight like a maidservant.
主的一个私人的能量是 Mahamaya, 而 Mahamaya 就像一个女仆一样，就站在主的视野之中。
And it is Mahamaya who uses her material modes to create, maintain, and demolish this world.
是 Mahamaya 本人运用了他的物质自然形态创造、维系和毁灭这个宇宙世界。
So this is her potency, and she is the controller. She is their controller.
这就是 Mahamaya 的力量，而 Mahamaya 才是控制者。
So Brahma tells Narada, all of us are under her, and we're bewildered by her.
所有在 Mahamaya 控制之下的生物全都受到他的困惑。
You shouldn't think that I have even a trace of Krishna's mercy.
你都不应该认为我得到了 Krishna 的一点一滴的仁慈。
So Brahma says, myself and my sons and all of our descendants, in other words, all the living entities, everyone in the material creation, we're all subject to her control.
所以 Brahma 就说到了我们所有人，我的儿子们还有我的后裔，全都是所有的生物全都是在他的在物质自然存在当中处在他的控制之下。
And Brahma tells Narada, you're also one of us, you're also bewildered, and you're speaking this wrong, you're speaking wrongly like this, that's why you're speaking wrongly.
Brahma 就对 Narada 说，你也是我们当中的一员，所以你才这样，你才说出这一番错误的话。
Brahma said, by the power of Krishna's Maya, I'm always deluded, and I become influenced by conceit.
Brahma 说，在 Krishna 的 Maya 虚幻能量的力量之下，我总是有被各种各样的欺骗所困惑。
And then I think I am the controller, I think I'm the grandfather, and I'm the guru of the universe.
我认为我自己是控制者，是这个宇宙的祖父，是他的灵性导师。
And I'm proud of my birth from the lotus navel of the Lord.
我也因为自己诞生于 Krishna 的莲花肚脐之上而感到自豪。
And I think I'm a great ascetic. I'm his great worshipper.
我自以为是一个了不起的苦行者，是 Krishna 的伟大的崇拜者。
Actually, I get overwhelmed by all the duties in managing the universe.
我由于要管理这个宇宙，我要履行无数的职责，所以我被所有这些职责给压倒了。
And I worry about the coming destruction of my planet. I know my planet's not eternal. In the course of time, it's going to have to end. So I worry about that.
我也知道我的星球也会在这个结束之际呢而被毁灭，我为此而忧心忡忡。
I'm afraid about the end of time.
我也恐惧这个时间，所有吞噬一切的时间。
All I want for myself, all I want is liberation.
我只想要自己得到解脱。
So Brahma, he understands being the Lord of the creation in the universe.Is not Krishna's mercy.
按照 Brahma 的理解，成为这个宇宙的创造者可不是得到 Krishna 仁慈的象征。
It gives me a lot of trouble.
实际上，这个带来了太多的麻烦。
All the responsibilities he have, sometimes they make him very proud, and then other times they give him all kinds of anxiety.
所有这些各式各样的职责，有的时候使 Brahma 变得骄傲，有的时候又使 Brahma 陷入各式种种的焦虑当中。
And Brahma says, sometimes I become bewildered by different kinds of false identities. I think myself to be the source of, I think everyone came from me.
Brahma 有的时候就被各式各样的这种称号头衔而弄得头晕脑胀，变得困惑，他以为他是所有生物的创造者。
I think I'm the beginning, the middle, and the end of the creation.
我认为我自己是所有创造的开始、中间和结尾。
I think I'm the first teacher of the Vedas and all the other scriptures.
我自视为是《韦达经》和所有其他经典的第一位老师。
And I think I'm the supreme authority. I appoint the demigods to their position.
我认为我是最至高无上的权威。我指派了各式各样的半神人。
I may be called self-born, that I took birth on my own, but that name is not actually true.
有人称我为自我诞生的人，但是这个名字并不是真的。
Actually, I was born from the lotus, coming from the navel of Garbhodaksha Vishnu.
实际上，我是从孕蛋之羊威树的肚脐的莲花肚脐上诞生的。
So just because the four Vedas and all the scriptures are all in my court, that doesn't prove that the Supreme Lord is merciful to me.
四韦达经和其他的主要经典都在我的大庭之上，这并不能证明。至尊主就对我，施以了仁慈。
No, the fact that all these personified scriptures are there, it means that my duty is to follow the scriptures.
所有这些经典的化身就在我的大庭之上，这证明了我必须要遵守他们的指定。
When I manage the universe, I have to follow everything according to the scriptures.
在我管理宇宙之际，我必须要遵守所有的经典训示。
So the scriptures, they may praise Brahma Loka, but Brahma, Lord Brahma himself, is aware that his planet is going to be destroyed very soon.
这些经典也许都在赞美 Brahma Loka, Brahma 星球，但是 Brahma 十分清楚，他的星球很快就会被毁灭。
Brahma will live longer than the demigods headed by Indra, but still he also has to die.
Brahma 的寿命也许要比以 Indra 为首的半神人们的寿命要长，但是仍然他也要死去。
So because Brahma is aware of this, sometimes he has to end his life, so Brahma is always afraid. Okay, so we will stop here.
好，那我们讲课部分到这里。
Are there any questions?
接下来我们来回答问题。Yes. 第一个问题，成长。Oh, 对 ，sorry. This devotee is recommended that because he's seeing that you are coughing, he said that you eat some pear and sugar, to steam them, and also massage some.
Okay, thank you very much.
Some place. Then the next question from Tu Ren. 禀拜姑妈，拉着莲花族，请您今天讲课中，男二的母女说 ，Brahma 得到了主最大的仁慈，请问您。一个人门徒得到了领导的最大的仁慈是什么？还是对于不同的门徒最大的仁慈是不同的？如何获得这仁慈感恩 Hare Krishna? Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. You mentioned in the class that Narada Muni said that Brahma has got the greatest mercy. So my question is that, what is the greatest mercy that a disciple can?Get from the spiritual master. This is the first part of the question.
The greatest mercy is to get love of God.
门徒从明镜导师那里得到最大仁慈，就是能够得到对神手的爱。
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The next, 对于不同的门徒最大仁慈，还是不同的。Or is that there are different kind of the mercy that disciple can get from the spiritual master or the same?
Different kinds of mercy? Yes. Just like Krishna says, when I'm very merciful to someone, I take everything away from them.
Krishna 说，当我对一个人仁慈的时候，我拿走他的一切。
Take away all our material all our material attachments. Take away all our pride. Take away all of our designations.
他会拿走我们的物质依附，拿走我们的骄傲，拿走我们的虚假的这些头衔。
Yeah, that's the greatest mercy.
这是最大的仁慈。
That's also mercy, right? Krishna takes everything away.
难道不是吗？
Then the mercy of the spiritual master may also come when he chastises you, and he tells you, you're a fool, you're stupid, you don't know anything.That's also mercy.
那灵性导师对门徒的仁慈还展现在他有的时候是训斥门徒，你是一个傻瓜，你是特别愚蠢的，你什么也不知道，这也是仁慈。
Do you like that mercy?
那你想得到这份仁慈吗
？Okay, go ahead.
How to get this mercy?
Be patient, you'll get it.
耐心点儿，你会得到的。Yes, he said. Yes, I want to get the mercy.
Okay.So you want to?
There is not yet any question on the chat box.
Okay. so we can finish here.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Yeah.
我这儿有一个那个 Tathagata 的问题，他之前发给我，我读一下。 是这个，是关于他在学习这个二十四起立课程的时候，遇到的一个问题，就是在学二十四起立那个课程的时候，有一道题是，他说有时会说念诵圣名不需要灌顶，并且讨论并解释这是什么意思，那么就是他不知道这个灌顶是怎么解释的，想。
想请咕噜方进一步的说明。这个问题就是说，学习二次起立课程的时候，有道问题是，对不起，我没有理解，这个您再读一遍好吗？就是这个问题是。
有时会说念诵圣名不需灌顶，请讨论并解释这是什么意思。这是这个二十四节课程当中的一道题，然后他想请姑姑把这个灌顶是怎么解释的，再讲一下。
There is a Arkham Mother, they asked that when she's learning the course for second initiation, there is a question that. When you chant the holy name, there's no need of Abhisheka. Like in the Tibetan tradition, the master will put the hand something like that on the disciple's head or give the disciple something that to show something like that. It is translated Guanbing, translated as Abhisheka.
Okay.
So the question is that when you chant the holy name, there is no need for Abhisheka. Please explain this.
Well, chanting of the holy name is the process in the Kali Yuga for self-realization, right? And chanting of the holy name is the means to perfection, and it is also perfection at the highest level.
唱诵圣名本身，它不仅仅是达到完美的方法，它自己也是唱诵圣名本身就是最高层面的完美。And
all the Vedic knowledge and all the other Vedic mantras, they're all included within the chanting of the holy name.
所有的伟达知识，所有的伟达曼陀罗都包括在圣名当中。Just
like Lord Shiva told his wife, you don't need to chant the 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu. He said, just chant the name of Lord Ram. The holy name of Lord Rama is equal to 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu. And then three names of Lord Rama are equal to one name of Lord Krishna.
而三遍 Rama 的圣名相当于念一次 Krishna 的圣名。
So if you're chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna, you're getting the benefit of 3,000 names of Vishnu.
所以倘若我们念诵一遍 Krishna 的圣名，就相当于3000次Vishnu的名字。
So we don't need to get any other, we don't need to do anything else but chant the holy name. You get all perfection, you get everything from the holy name.
从圣名就可以达到所有的完美，达到一切。
The holy name is described as Chintamani.
圣名被描述说它是 Chintamani 点金石。
Nam Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto Binat Nam Nama Namino.The holy name of Lord Krishna is described to be the wish-fulfilling substance which satisfies all of our desires.
这个诗节的意思就是说，圣名是，满足我们所有愿望的如愿的核心。
Right, Chintamani, it can transform everything into gold.Or it can set whatever you want something to become, it can become just simply by the touch of the Chintamani stone.
就是这个 Chintamani 点金石，就是你想要什么，你就一触碰这个 Chintamani 点金石，它就能得转变成你想要的。
So.The holy name is described to be like Chintamani.
圣名被描述为 Chintamani, 点心石，如愿石。
And it is described as Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. It has consciousness, it has form, everything is there within the holy name.
那么它也是，Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha，它是有知觉的，它也有形象，一切都在圣名中当中。
And it is completely pure, and it is always liberated.
圣名是永远的纯洁的，它是永恒解脱的。
And it is not different from Lord Krishna.
圣名和 Krishna 本人没有区别。
One devotee was giving a class, and Prabhupada was listening. So the devotee was explaining about the holy name, and he said, "Krishna is in his name." But Prabhupada said, "No," said Krishna is his name, no different.
有一位奉献者在讲课。Prabhupada 在听他的讲课，这个奉献者就讲 Krishna 的圣名的时候说 ，Krishna 就在他的圣名当中。然后帕帕德说，不 ，Krishna 就是他的圣名 ，Krishna 和圣名没有区分。
Yes. Okay. So, if you have the holy name of Krishna, you have the greatest wealth, the greatest treasure.
如果你有了 Krishna 的圣，人们有了 Krishna 的圣名，人们就拥有了最大的财富，最大的宝藏。
There's nothing lacking if you have the holy name.
人们拥有了，谁拥有了圣名，他就什么也不缺。
So you don't have to worry about Abhishek.
所以不用担心灌顶这件事。
Just chant the holy name.
只要念诵圣名就好了。
Yeah, we say chant and be happy.
我们说念诵并快乐。
Okay, yes.
Yes, now there's a question from Shama Saki Devadasi. Hare Krishna, 禀拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉献者，为什么 Brahma 害怕死亡？如果的现有的躯体不死亡，他不还得在物质星球吗？This is the first part of the question. That why Brahma is afraid of death? But if there's no death of the body, then he will have to take birth in the material planet. So why should Brahma afraid of death?
Well, Srila Prabhupada explains that at the time of death, everyone is fearful.
Srila Prabhupada 曾经说过，在死亡之际，每个生物都在恐惧。
Everyone. Don't think that you're going to be, you know, we will all have a little apprehension, a little worry at the time of death.
我们所有人在死亡之际都会有这种就是恐惧之心。
So Brahma is a living entity, he's a jiva, he's like us. So he's also fearful of death. He has a position, he's a very big position, he's the head of the universe, the grandfather, above all the demigods. And if he's going to die, then he's worried that, you know, what will happen to him, where will he go?
Brahma 也是一个非灵魂，也是像我们一样的生物。所以在死亡，他虽然是整个宇宙的首领，是在所有半世人之上，但是他也是祖先。但是他死亡的时候，他也担心，不知道他自己下一世会去哪里。
Just because he's Brahma doesn't mean that he will always go back to Godhead. Sometimes Brahma also takes birth again in the material world.
不是因为他是Brahma，贵为Brahma的地位，他就一定能回归神首。他也可能还在物质世界再次投生。
So he's thinking about that. What will be his destiny?
所以他就在想着这一点，就是他的下一个目标是什么。 She continued to ask that, is that at the time of death, Brahma forget Krishna? Afraid of forget. Is worried that he will forget Krishna.
Well, yes, that's one thing.
是的，这也是其中的一个理由。
We certainly all want to be in a situation at the time of death that we can remember Krishna.
我们都希望在死亡之际呢，就是在我们处的环境是，我们不会忘记 Krishna。
But we don't know what kind of situation we will meet at the time of death.
Next.
Yes.
在他偷走牧牛童和牛犊之后，向主 Krishna 祈祷，想投生在文达本。 既然想投生在文大文，又可干嘛害怕死亡呢？ 明知他四个头的躯体无法留在文大文，我有些糊涂，请不如解释解除的遗憾，明白你。 After Brahma stole those companion from Krishna, those little calf, and he prayed to Krishna that he want to take birth, took birth in Vrindavan. Then why should Brahma be afraid of death since he want to take birth in Vrindavan in his next life? I'm puzzled.
Well, we may want things, but it doesn't mean we always get what we want. We have to be worthy, we have to be qualified. So it's a very special birth to take birth in Vrindavan.
我们有这个愿望，但是我们可能得不到我们的愿望，我们可能不配得到我们的愿望，我们可能没有资格得到我们的愿望。要重生在文达本是一个特殊的出生。Yeah. Next one from Dasi, Dimbai Gumaraj, 请问非人格把 Vishnu, Brahma, Shiva 看成一样的，怎么理解？哪里？ She wants to know that the impersonal is regard Vishnu, Brahma, and Shiva as the same. How to understand this idea?
Well, there, the impersonalists, they see everything the same. Not only Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, they see everyone, everything the same. It's all one. And they see everyone as Brahman, right? Everyone is spiritual. Everyone is spiritual energy. So they don't see any difference between one and another. Because that's impersonalism. Means you're not a person, I'm not a person, we're all just simply Brahman.
非人格主义者，他们把一切都看成是一，同一的。所有的生物不仅仅是 Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva 是，一都一样，所有的生物都是一样的，都是 Brahman, 都是梵，都是灵性的能量，都没区别，都是一同一的，因为他们是非人格的，所以，就是我和你都没有区别，我们都是梵。 他们没有人格外面。下一个，真真，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru Maharaj， 顶拜您甜美的莲花族，顶拜所有奉献者。想请问 Guru， 什么会让一个人在奉献佛的道路上走偏了呢？真真 wants to know。 One will deviate from spiritual path. So what's the reason for that?
We deviate from the spiritual path because we're attracted to the material energy.
一个人偏离灵修的道路是因为 他在物质能量作战。
We want to enjoy the material world. We have material desires. And so we deviate from spiritual practice.
人们想要享受这个物质世界，他们有物质的愿望，所以才会偏离。 Next one 是红冕，顶拜公路，我对圣名没有品位。 只是每天机械地完成任务，我很痛苦，我怎么做才最好呢？ I have no taste for the holy name. I'm only mechanically finished my duty. I felt very painful. So what's the best way, best for me? What's the best method for me? What should I do?
You should do more service. Serve the devotees. Do service for the devotees, and then they will bless you with a taste for the holy name.
您应当为奉献者做更多的服务，然后呢，这个奉献者们会祝福您对圣名有品位了。
Okay.
Chaitanya, Rupa, Devadasi, 顶拜Guru和所有人，有人说念一遍圣名相当于念阿弥陀佛3000遍，有这个说法吗？ Someone says that one holy name equals to 3000 Amitabha, the holy name of Amitabha. Is it correct?
I never heard before.
这个说法我以前没听说。
Amitabha Buddha, Amitabha, that's, you know, it's nothing to do with Krishna consciousness. It's Buddhism. It's no connection. It's not the holy name. It's not the name of the Lord. They're chanting the name of Amitabha Buddha. The Amitabha Buddha. So he's not it's not in our line. It has nothing to do with Krishna consciousness, so we don't relate it at all.
这个，它不是跟这个是佛教当中的，跟Krishna之间没关系，它既不是圣名，它也不是主的名字，这是阿米塔的Buddha的名字，它也不是这个传我们这个传系当中的，不属于不在Krishna之觉当中，所以没有联系，跟我们这个没有联系。 That's all.
Okay. So we will stop here. So thank Guru Mani for all her translation, and thank all the devotees for participation. And thank Sati for. Thank Padmamukhi Mataji. Yeah? Thank.
Yes.
All the devotees. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Thank you, Maharaj.